गुड मॉर्निंग डियर चिल्ड्रन, आई वेलकम यू ऑल इन इंग्लिश क्लासरूम एंड आवर टुडेज टॉपिक इज प्रेजेंट परफेक्ट कंटिन्यूस टेंस। ओके चिल्ड्रन, बिफोर आई स्टार्ट दिस वीडियो आई जस्ट वांट टू रिमाइंड यू दैट वी हैव डन सिंपल पास्ट प्रेजेंट कंटिन्यूस एंड येस्टरडे वी हैव डन प्रेजेंट परफेक्ट टेंस। ऑल राइट, and although present perfect and present perfect continuous is not given in chapter number 2, it is given in chapter number 3, but I had taken all the present collectively, and after completing present we will go with past tense, means with chapter number 3. Okay, so shall I start the video today? All right children, as we have discussed uses of present perfect continuous and present perfect tense and present continuous, simple present also. Similarly, we will discuss uses of present perfect continuous. Alright, see, action that started in the past and are still continuing. The actions which are started in the past and still they are continuing, they are going on, that will there be in present perfect continuous. Action that has finished just a short while ago, that will always be in present perfect continuous tense. Let us discuss the helping verb of present perfect continuous, that is has been and have been. Has been is used with the singulars and have been is used with the plurals. This is how you will form present perfect continuous, by following the syntax: subject plus has been slash have been, means you have to use one, has been or have been, plus verb first form plus ing. Children, whenever there will be continuous, you have to use ing form of the verb, as we were using in present continuous verb first form plus ing. Similarly, we have to use verb first form plus ing with present perfect continuous. Alright, present perfect, we have to use has and have. Present perfect continuous, has been or have been. Continuous is there, verb first form plus ing. This is how you will learn. Okay, this will be easy for you, that whenever two combinations are there, means that perfect and continuous. So perfect part is has been, and continuous part is verb first form plus ing. Alright children? Okay. Now see some examples. I have been waiting for the bus since 7 o'clock. Children, see here in this sentence what is there? I started waiting at 7 o'clock, right? And still I am waiting. I am still waiting. So here is an action that has started in the past and still it is continuing. Still it is going on. So that will be in the present perfect continuous tense. Let us take another example. It has been raining for 15 minutes. Children, what does it mean? Means that that it started raining 15 minutes ago. It started raining 15 minutes ago, but still it is raining. All right. Still it is raining means the thing that has started in the past, this here it has been started and now it is going on here also, it is going on right now also, right? See, I have been waiting to see the doctor for 2 hours. Again, I have been waiting to see the doctor. See on the timeline. See, The person was waiting to see the doctor for 2 hours. Means, if at 5 p.m. If the person has gone to the clinic, and then if he started waiting over there, after 2 hours means at 7 o'clock. Still, at 7 o'clock, the person is waiting for the doctor. So it will be like action that has been started in the past and still going on. Alright, children? Okay, now see some more examples. He has been playing tennis since he was a child. He was a child. Now you will get the exact use of since and for also in present perfect continuous. That he has been playing tennis since he was a child. That is a point of time. When we decide a point of time, we always use since. Right? Means since he was a child, from childhood, when he was a child, from that time till now, he is playing tennis. Alright? Now see, next, if we say like this, he has been playing tennis for 20 years, means a specific time limit is not given, a specific point of time is not given. They are not saying since he was a child, means this is the exact point of time. This is the period of time. Alright, this is the period of time. So here we will use for. This will be more clear to you. Just see some more examples. She has been learning English for 8 months. For 8 months. 8 months. 8 months we cannot consider from where? From January to August. From February to October. No, we don't know. Alright, so here 8 months means the period of time. If we'll say like this, from January, since January, since October, like this, right? She has been learning English since last October. So this is the point of time, means from the October. We are now at this point. We are now on October. Okay, see, from here means the learning started from here. This was in the past. Okay, since it is a since we are talking about the point of time, that means this is the point. Okay, and from this point it was started. Okay, now see another example. We have been living in this town for a very long time. See, again, we have been living in this town for a very long time. A very long time, again, point of time is not given, period of time is given. No specific time or point is given. No, isn't it? Yes. We are not having point of time. We are having period of time. That is why we are using for. Period of time means whenever exact specific time is not given. Right? Like that. So, if we will see on the timeline, this is the long time. Long time means long time. No specific time is given. Okay? This suggests duration. This suggests duration, like that, period of time. For suggests duration or period of time, not point of time. Point of time suggested by since. Alright? Okay. See, children, in this next example, we have been living in this town since. We have been living in this town since 1980. So again we have used since. That means again we are at point 1980. For a very long time, no specific time is given. Okay, but here 1980 is given. Now the time will start from 1980. Here we don't know from where it will start. So this is the basic difference between for and since. Where you have to use since, where you have to use for. Now, I hope it is clear to you all. Okay. Now see, one more example. It has been raining all morning. All morning. We don't know from when it was started. Okay. But in this sentence, it has been raining since 4 a.m. This 4 a.m. is the specific time. Point of time. Alright. So, if there will be a point of time, we'll use since. When there will be period of time, we'll use for. This. For. Okay. Fine. Now let us discuss second use of present perfect continuous. Action that finished just a short while ago. Children, when our action had just finished a short while ago, we'll use present perfect continuous. Let us understand this with the help of example. Saloni has been watching TV. That means Saloni was watching TV a short while ago. Now she has stopped. She has stopped watching now. Okay, but a short while ago she was watching. We are not talking about 5 minutes ago and 10 minutes ago. We are not giving the specific time. Alright. But has been watching TV, showing that Saloni was watching TV a short while ago. Take another example. Some stray cattle have been treading over these flower beds. That means these stray cattle have been treading, but now they have gone away. Okay? So this is showing that a short while ago they were treading, but now they have gone away. They are not treading now. They are not treading now. They have gone away. So this is how we'll use present perfect continuous when we talk about action that had finished just a short while ago. Just few minutes ago. Like that. Okay? Children, I hope this topic is clear to you all, and if any queries are there regarding this topic, please do write in the comment section. We will meet in the next video and we'll discuss chapter number 3, verb expressing the past. Till then, take care of yourself. Have a nice day.